talk to us a little about media day today. We seen Earl put on a good workout, getting ready for Ugas fight April 16th.
Man, it was good, man. It was good, man. It was good to see everybody out here. He's been pushing himself. He's been working very hard. He's been sparring like 14, 15 rounds. So it's really good, man. Everything is good.
You know, man, I've never seen Errol act like that on the bag. It seemed like he was showing, you know, his power, his speed a little bit more.
Over time, think about that. Wasn't it 3 minute round, 15 minutes straight. From none but a hard shot. Not pity patting the bag. Listen, showing an exhibition of his conditioning.
And so in this training camp, was that more of the focus, being pressured, showing, you know, endurance and strength and power and everything?
I think that it has been, man. It really has. Big guys, just what big guys, big fast guys, very strong. Really guys that really going to push him and can endure, because we know that Ugas is going to be there. There's nothing that's going to take him away. He's going to be there. He's going to be in the ring. He's not going anywhere. You're going to have to make him quit. Make him, because he's not. He's very... He got escaped six times. He got caught. He's a guy with a lot of determination. So you have to take the will of him.
I know you study boxing. And what did you study in the Ugas Pacquiao game? I mean, Pacquiao fight.
I really didn't see a boxing out of it. I was there at the fight. I really haven't watched that fight. I think that Pacquiao's a different style. So I've watched other fights of his. But, you know, I'll touch a little Pacquiao because he was more aggressive and very dominant. Which he liked that a lot of fighters, but this one he was sunning him and pushing him around and kind of manhandling him. So he's not gonna be able to do that with Errol. So I didn't watch that one in particular. That's a little bit of it, but mostly him fighting other guys.
What was some of those
other
fights? Was it the Porter fight?
No Porter fight. It was a guy, other left-handed kid from Philly. I forget his name. I mean, it was several fights. I don't remember the opponents. I've been watching him nonstop.
It seemed like a lot of people are saying that Spence is different after the car crash, after when he had the Danny fight. You've been with him all his career. What do you think? Are they seeing different? Do you see
everybody? I want to see their medical license. That's all. Right, they act like, how can they tell you different? What about him is different? They can't put a pinpoint on or a finger on what exactly is different. So that's the question I want to ask. What is it about him is different?
To me, he was better in that fight. Right. He was more technical.
He boxed. Listen, he shut a pound of a top what, 4 months away down? Shut him out. Then went around. Think about that. How do you do that coming off a car accident? Right? Think about it. He shut him out. Nobody ever shut him out. When he fought Sean, when he fought Keith, those were tight decisions.
And you just mentioned Keith, if the proper fight doesn't materialize.
No, we're not worried about the thing's gonna materialize.
It's gonna materialize?
You're not gonna step backwards.
That's the goal.
There's no disrespect to Keith Thurman, but he's not that guy yet. Who would he just fight?
Mario.
Okay, yeah, he's not there yet. He's good though, he's good. I like Mario Barrios also.
And then another one of y'all world champions in Charlo. He has a big fight with Cabano coming up. Talk to us about his preparation. It's a rematch. They got a draw in July. Talk to us what you've been changing to actually
get that
win.
Well, really just keeping him on the situation. The last 4 rounds are going to be the first 4 rounds, first 8 rounds, first 10 rounds, where he came out like losing. And like you're behind. It's all about what I looked up at the scorecard, and it was really subjective because it was a Showtime analyst. And they said what they said. I said, man, listen, they got you behind. He picked it up, so he don't go out, and then they got you behind.
So that's the thing. You're starting the 13th round next fight.
Right, 13th round, he's on it. And you see the last 4 rounds, how he was. He was trying to survive.
And a few more for me. We got Rolly versus Tank in May. Who you got in that fight?
I'm a Javonte Davis fan. And I think Javonte's the guy.
The guy at 135?
I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that I have 135. I think he's the guy. No, I think he's the guy at 135. Listen, man, you think about this. Out of 4 or 5 fighters in the world, it's only, you got 4 or 5 fighters in the world who make their money. See what I'm saying? I'm not, all the other fighters who think they're popping, they get paid. Mm-hmm. This pay-per-view sale, Canelo pay-per-view sale, Air pay-per-view sale, Tyson Field pay-per-view sale, and then Josh pay-per-view. There's 5 people in the world who make their own money. You understand? Not get paid. And that's the difference. Bunter Davis won those guys.
Speaking about his star power, just mentioned that this might be his last fight with Mayweather promotion. Do you think he should be on his own, be a free agent, since he does generate those sales and he doesn't really need a traditional promoter?
I think it's up to him. I can't make a judgment on what he wants to do. I want him to be happy. If that's the case, do that. If it's not, hey, I'm saying.
And last one for me, Canelo versus Bivol. Who you got in that fight?
I just want to see a good fight. I'm a fan of boxing. I'm going to just see a really good competitive fight.
Thank you so much, Derrick.
You got it. You got it. Ain't doing much. Take a step back. Cause it's Elie Seckbach.